Good morning. I'm Dr. Sangeeta Desai, Assistant Professor at Patil Medical College in Obstetric and Gynecology Department. I will be talking on comprehensive abortion care. If you see major causes of maternal death in India, the abortion comprises 8% of causes of maternal death in India. So that is a preventable cause. So this unsafe abortion leading to complications such as sepsis and bleeding, which may lead to death, or if the woman survives, she suffers from chronic illnesses like Sheehan syndrome. So that can be prevented by doing the legalization of the abortion. What is the induction of abortion? Induction of abortion is a deliberate termination of pregnancy before viability of fetus, and induced abortion can be legal or illegal. So until MTB Act was passed, proving abortion remained punishable under Indian law. And in case of death due to abortion procedure, there was punishment of up to 10 years imprisonment and fine. So in India, abortion was legalized by Medical Termination of Pregnancy MTB Act 1971 and enforced in 1972, and provisions were revised in 1975. This amendment was done in 2002, and the term lunatic was replaced by mentally ill. And the MTB place has to be approved by the district level committee and chaired by DHO. That was a modification done, which was initially by the central government. So this amendment has an implication, like it has made a restriction simplified, and which can be done at a district level only. So provider can get a site approved providing abortion under MTB Act up to 12 or 20 weeks of gestation, which comes under protective cover of MTB Act. So abortion is termed legal only when the following conditions are met. The termination should be done by medical practitioner approved by the Act. Termination done at place approved under Act. And termination done for the conditions and within the gestation prescribed by the Act. Other requirements of rules and regulations should be complied with. So, aim of MTB Act is to improve the maternal health scenario by preventing large number of unsafe abortions and consequent high incidence of maternal mortality and morbidity, and to legalize the abortion services, to promote access to the safe abortion services to a woman, decriminalizes abortion seeker, offers protection to medical practitioners who otherwise would be penalized under Indian Penal Code. So it is, if you see this MTB Act in a legal framework, it has laid down rules and regulations. So rules in that, the pregnancy should be terminated, where it should be terminated, and who can do that. It come under MTB rule, which is controlled by the central government. And this act also grants the central government power to make a rule, and state government has given power to make up regulations. The regulations includes the forms for the opinion, maintenance of the record, and custody of the forms and reporting of the cases. So when the pregnancy can be terminated up to 20 weeks, it can be terminated with the consent of the woman. If the woman is below 18 years or mentally ill, then with the consent of the guardians. With the opinion of the registered medical practitioner, form in a good faith under certain circumstances, and opening of the single RMP for termination up to 12 weeks, and opening of two RMP required for termination of pregnancy between 12 to 20 weeks. For the approval of the site, up to 12 weeks, the site is needed, the gynecological examination or labor table, resuscitation and sterilization equipment, drugs and parenteral fluids, backup facility for the treatment of shock, and facilities for the transportation. And approval of up to 20 weeks, the requirements that are for the 12 weeks plus operation table and instruments for performing abdominal gynecological surgeries, the anesthetic equipment, resuscitation equipment, sterilization equipment, drugs and parenteral fluids notified for the emergency use and notified by the Government of India from time to time. So in up to 12 weeks of gestation, who can do the MTP? The rule says the practitioner, registered medical practitioner, who has assisted 20 or performed at least 5 cases of MTP independently in a hospital established or maintained or as a training institute approved by this purpose by the government. And for up to 20 weeks of pregnancy, the practitioner who holds postgraduate degree in or diploma in obstetric gynecology, or practitioner who has completed 6 months of postjob in obstetric and gynecology, or practitioner who has at least 1 year experience of practice of OBGYN at hospital which has a hall facilities, or a practitioner registered in a state medical registry immediately before commencement of the act, and experience in the practice of obstetric gynecology for a period of not less than 3 years. So what are the indications? In indications, there are the three types of indications. One is medical, social, and usually. In a medical indication, it is to save the life of the mother which is having severe cardiac disease, chronic glomerular nephritis, malignant hypertension, intractable hyperemesis gravidarum, cervical and breast malignancies, diabetes mellitus with retinopathy, epilepsy, or psychiatric illness. Social indications is to prevent a grave injury which woman can suffer in physical or mental health, that is pregnancy caused by rape in case of major or minor girl, and in case of mentally imbalanced woman, or if it is a result of failure of contraception. And in 80% of cases, it is limited to parents women having unplanned pregnancy with low socioeconomic status. So what are the eugenic indications? The substantial risk is there the child being born with a serious mental and physical abnormalities, like a structural or chromosomal abnormalities, then the fetus because of any teratogenic drugs or radiation exposure in early pregnancy, or rubella and viral infection first trimester. So MTB service should be accessible, affordable, and acceptable. So what is my comprehensive abortion care? The purpose of comprehensive abortion care is that to reduce the unsafe abortion, because all the patient cannot approach to tertiary centers for the MTB. So at the peripheral level, this comprehensive abortion care is provided to the woman, which contains the three elements like pre-procedure counseling, safe abortion procedure, and post-abortion care. The methods of abortion will be medical method of abortion, then manual vacuum aspiration and electronic vacuum aspiration. So in medical methods of abortion, the commonly used drugs are mifepristone and misoprostol. The Drug Controller General of India approved the use of mifepristone in April 2002 and misoprostol in December 2006 for a termination of pregnancy up to 49 days of gestation. In December 2008, the mifepristone and misoprostol and 4 tablets of misoprostol, the combi pack was approved by the Central Drugs Standard Control, because the termination can be done up to 63 weeks of gestation if you use a 4 tablet of misoprostol instead of 2 tablets. What are the contraindications for medical abortions? The medical contraindications are undiagnosed adnexal masses if you are suspecting ectopic pregnancy, then hemorrhagic disorders, the ICD in place, bronchial asthma. The prostaglandins other than the misoprostol should not be used. Misoprostol has a weak bronchodilator action. Then the current use of long-term corticosteroid, current anticoagulant therapy, uncontrolled seizure disorders. Also, if she is anemic hemoglobin less than 8 g/cl, then uncontrolled hypertension, BP more than 160/100, and inherited porphyria. What are the social indications? Social and psychological indications are woman if it is she is unable to take responsibility of the her condition, or she is not mentally stable. An anxious woman wanting quick abortion, or sometimes there is a comprehension barrier or language barrier, or the healthcare provider is unable to give unable to counsel and unable to take an informed consent, and if she is not willing for vacuum aspiration abortion in case of failure. So these are the contraindications for medical termination, medical method of termination. Then we have to take a special precaution. Patient is with uterine scar, that is previous history of myomectomy or previous cesarean section. If she is on any anti-tubercular drug, the efficacy of drug may decrease, and there are more chance of failure to require surgical abortion. If there is allergy to mifepristone, misoprostol, or other prostaglandins. What are the limitations of medical method? The abortion can be offered only at early stage, that is up to 63 days. At least 3 clinical visits are required. The first visit for the giving mifepristone tablet, second visit for the misoprostol tablet, and then follow-up visit. Then what is the other limitation is the risk of malformation occurs if the pregnancy continues. Then there is the outcome is unpredictable. It may incomplete abortion, or pregnancy can continue. Then it takes longer time than vacuum aspiration. The mean duration of bleeding will be 9.5 days. advantages is less invasive than vacuum aspiration. No instrumentation is required. It is similar to natural miscarriage. There is no possibility of side effect of the drug. That is anesthetic drugs. Then in a clinical visit on day 1, 200 mg of mifepristone is given orally, and if she is RS negative, NTD is given. Then day 2, second visit is done on third day, that is keeping misoprostol 400 microgram orally, and the third visit will be on day 15, that you have to confirm the and ensure the completeness of the abortion. The contraceptive advice is given on visit 2 or visit 3. Then the follow-up of the medical method abortion is done. Then the complete abortion will occur in 95 to 99%. Then there will be heavy bleeding in 1 to 2% only, and the heavy bleeding requiring blood transfusion will be 0.1 to 0.2%. So it's very less. Sometimes there will be incomplete abortion requiring other methods in 1 to 2%. What are the other indications for medical method of abortion? Are the missed abortion, incomplete abortion, and vesicular wound. We have to take a detailed history and examination, record complete history like menstrual history, obstetric history, contraceptive history, and rule out all the contraindications, then do physical examination, check for pallor, then check for the blood pressure, then do cardiovascular and respiratory system examination, pelvic examination, per speculum, per vaginal examination to confirm the period of gestation, to rule out the ectopic pregnancy, and to identify any fibroid. So that we can take up precautions, because there is possibility of increased bleeding, and look for the infection. Then recommended investigations of hemoglobin, complete urine examination, and blood grouping and typing. And the optional ultrasonography is done especially if the woman is unsure of LMP, or she has irregular periods, or the uterine size and menstrual rate do not match, or there is suspicion of ectopic pregnancy or fibroid during PG examination. In the training program, the trainee has to acquire the competency in assessing the uterine size and biomanual examination. He has to observe at least 10 MTP cases, assess at least 10 MTP cases, and perform at least 5 MTP independently under supervision. Then the essentials of the this comprehensive abortion care trainee is he or she will be able to do pre-procedure counseling, and they will help the woman to take a decision of termination. Then they should inform the procedure, its implication, and there should be a confidentiality should be maintained. Then there should be motivation for the contraception, and should discuss the family, social, and personal issues also. So he is requiring counseling skills also, and clinical assessment, then infection prevention and instrument processing he should learn. Then he should be able to disassemble and assemble the parts of the MVI aspirator, and he should be able to give post-operative contraceptive method advice, and this CSC service delivery should be optionalized after training is finished. So Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, 2016, the first visit this orally 200 mg mifepristone, second visit misoprostol, and patient has to stay at clinic for at least 4 hours. Then instructions should be given to the patient. The side effects like nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, headache, fatigue, fever more than 100, dizziness, bleeding should be evaluated for the, if there is heavy bleeding, should be evaluated for the hypovolemia. And if she should report in case she has excessive bleeding, soaking of more than 2 pads per hour. And the mean duration of bleeding period is 9 to 16 days. And the bleeding, heavy bleeding lasts for 1 to 4 hours. That coincides with the expulsion of products of conception. Then third visit on day 15, we will have to take a clinical history and note the signs and symptoms. Pelvic examination should be carried out to ensure the completeness of the abortion. Sonography should be advised if the examination doesn't confirm the expulsion of POC, and this woman should not leave the facility without contraceptive advice and counseling. Then the follow-up instructions are given regarding the prevention of sexually transmitted diseases, and she should report back if there is no period within six weeks of completion of abortion process. The antibiotics, if she is lactating, the azithral 500 mg OD for 3 days, and she is non-lactating, doxycycline 100 mg BD for 7 days. Then contraception after abortion, it can be hormonal, progestin only can be started as soon as day of misoprostol administration, and the other method include oral contraceptive injectable methods like DMPA. So IUCT can be inserted after confirmed completion of the abortion, provided there is no any infection. The condom can be used as soon as she resumes sexual activity after abortion, and female sterilization can be done after first menstrual cycle. Vasectomy chosen can be done independent of the procedure. So the factors which influence the abortion services are social causes, then physical access to the medical facility, then policy of the government and economics of the patient. So this comprehensive abortion care is a government India policy which makes abortion services accessible to the rural peoples also. Thank you.